Well, we're out here today because 2 years ago we measured volatilization of PAHs off of freshly applied coal tar seal coat, and we found some extraordinarily high rates and numbers. And so we want to verify those, and we're also at the same time sampling much more intensively and with several other instruments that we didn't have last time to try to do the best job we possibly can to quantify this volatilization flux and see how important an air contaminant is.
At the same time, we're going to be doing some runoff experiments so we can look at the effects, the potentially toxic effects of stormwater runoff from recently seal-coated parking lots on aquatic biota. Somewhere between when you put the product on the surface and when it dries and you scrape it back off, you're losing some of those PAHs. And so the question is, are they going into the air?
So the same patch of ground behind us, 50 by 50 foot square area, was seal coated 2 years ago, and we sampled air concentrations right on the surface with a thing called a hat sampler that's a round steel disc that has a high volume air sampler at the center, and it samples the surface air layer. We sampled concentrations about 4 feet off the surface with a second high volume sampler, and with those two and with wind speed, you can make an estimate of the total flux of PAHs to the air, the total amount of volatilization. And what we found from that initial study in our first sample, 2 hours after the seal coat was applied, was an extremely high concentration of PAHs in air and a really high volatilization rate. Well, we're back today because in that study we sampled relatively infrequently right after sampling and spread over a whole year. And we realized when we look at the results from it that a whole lot of the action, a whole lot of the volatilization was happening in the first few minutes or hours after application.
We're going to collect samples more frequently than we did the first time around. And so we'll be able to have a much better description of what those PAH concentrations are in the first few days after application.
There is a lot of evidence out there that the runoff, if it does rain soon after the seal coat is applied, is very toxic. There have been 2 fish kills that we know of when it has rained within a day or so of application of seal coat in the streams that those parking lots drained into. So we're doing a much more controlled experiment than that, where we're going to simulate runoff to try to see how toxic the runoff is and for how long.
And then we're going to do all of these same types of sampling, but we're going to do them in a few weeks on a surface that has been treated with a different type of seal coat, one that has an asphalt base as opposed to the coal tar base.
The coal tar product has now been banned in Austin, where we are. We had to get special permission to do this. And in more than a dozen other U.S. cities and in the state of Washington, and the alternative is this asphalt-based product. So we also want to test it to see how environmentally friendly or safe it is.
Important to see how substantial the difference really is from an environmental point of view between the two products.
The 3 major findings, I would say, of the studies of seal coat, the first one is simply that it has extremely high concentrations of PAHs. And that's in the product, it's in dust that's swept off of the parking lot, it's in runoff, it's in air concentrations next to the parking lots. So it's just a really strong source of this group of contaminants.
A second major finding is that it doesn't stay where you put it. Coal tar seal coat wears off. You can see it on the parking lot around us, that you can see the asphalt through the seal coat. And that's normal, and that's why applicators recommend that you reapply, have it reapplied every 3, 4, 5 years. The question is, where does it go? And we found that it comes off in stormwater runoff, it gets tracked into people's homes, it ends up in stormwater detention ponds, it ends up in our lakes and rivers, and it ends up in the air. So there are a number of different environmental compartments that are affected.
Yeah, and to elaborate on one of the things Barbara just mentioned as a major finding is our studies of lake sediment chemistry around the United States have shown that concentrations of the PAHs have been increasing in urban lakes across the U.S. for the last 30 or 40 years, and that the dominant source of PAHs to those lakes is the coal tar-based pavement seal coat.